Victorian families will no longer need a planning permit to build a granny flat on their property, with the state government cutting council red tape. Experts say it's a small step towards solving the housing crisis. Eliza Rugg has the details.
Helen wants to build a granny flat on her Brunswick property so her family can stick together.
I have an elderly mother. She may need to move in with me at some stage.
From next month, granny flats under 60 square metres won't need a planning permit on properties 300 square metres or larger, where there are no flooding or environmental overlays.
This is a really sensible and practical change to drive the construction of more second homes.
There's no restrictions on how they can be used.
This provides a great second home that can be rented out.
They'll still require a building permit and need to meet residential design code. They also cannot be subdivided or separately sold off from the main home. It's estimated 230,000 properties in Melbourne could be suitable. Hotspots include Glen Waverley, Roeville and Berwick in the east, Rye and Mount Martha on the Mornington Peninsula, Greensboro and Eltham in the north, as well as Sunbury and Hoppers Cross in the west.
This is another useful measure to try and speed up the process of approval for properties that make it easier to add to our housing stock.
Nick Todd is busy building tiny homes in Tullamarine and delivering them to backyards.
We just need to find employees to keep up with it, and it'll be great.
So granny flats definitely aren't just for grandparents. This tiny home is going to a family with a teenage son. It costs $80,000. The most expensive ones here cost $300,000.
Most of them go off a gas bottle, and electric would be just a plug-in. It's a day setup.
Eliza Rugg, Nine News.